It's really common to have to handle flows of data between components. How do you do that? By using props and events. Keep in mind, props down, events up. Changing a prop involves a one-way flow from parent to child, and not vice versa. We're going to send data down from host.view, which is our parent component, to a child component. Let's go ahead and create that child component. I'm going to create a new file. It's going to be called bookingList.view. And we'll go ahead and type view and use that fabulous snippet extension to just scaffold out all the elements. Okay, so let's see how this works. We need to get the child component ready to accept props by listing them as an object with types delineated. We're going to show the bookings for our cruises. So let's add the props as an array of bookings. And we're going to add that right into our script file like this. Script block like this, sorry. So we're going to pair our props in the child with a computed property. Computed properties are useful for doing computational tasks in a component. We're going to take the data sent in the bookings array and derive the total cost of a booking for display. So let's add a computed property. And that can go right under the props. To watch out for commas a little bit. So now we have props and a computed property. Now let's go ahead and add a template to display the info that we are computing. So we'll add the section and we'll pop it right into the template, just like that. Okay. So we're going to grab the booking data, loop through it, display the cabins, and derive the total cost with that computed property. Now we have to make the child component visible to the parent component. So let's go back to host view. And at the top of the script block, we're going to just import booking list from booking list view. And we have some code completion, which works very nicely. And we're going to add it to a components object here. So we'll just add it right here in components, and we can pop it right at the top. And there's a to-do element in here, so we're going to add another component later on. And then the last thing we have to do is add the component using kebab case. So we're going to pop it right into that to-do area right here. So where it says to add the booking form and add the booking list, we'll add the booking list right here. We're going to add a booking form later. Okay, and you can see that kebab case, booking list, and then bookings, the prop is going to be sent through this child, through this parent, and down to the child where it's going to be handled. So let's check out our page as it's been building and rebuilding. And you can see that we have embedded a prop to send booking data down to the child component. And you can test it by changing a value in the bookings data and watching it propagate. So if we would be looking for the bookings information here, we have the name of sample, price is zero. We change that price to 100, and we're in host, remember? And then you can see that it changes right away, $100. In our next video, we're going to go ahead and create a form so that we can start sending data from the child back up to the parent. So stay tuned.